Well, that brings us into racket number two.
We're there?
It's interesting you say that.
Yeah.
Because we're going to talk about listing agent versus buyer agent.
Byron
right?
loves oh, and Byron okay. and here, loves buyer's agent.
I have some
agents.
Interesting here's what worldly I'll, insight
let,
here.
Let me frame this up for you a little bit. I think it's quite...
I'm like getting all excited.
I see that.
It's quite obvious
I feel
that,
like you've been excited the whole time. I feel like I need some of your energy. Yeah.
It's quite obvious that if you're an agent, if you're a broker, to me it's quite obvious yeah. that you should be collecting listings, you should yes. be controlling the inventory.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
What's also obvious to me... Mm-hmm. is that if you are not going to have listings, you are going to pay 40% or close
or
to
more.
It, or more even, for buyer leads. And you're not going to have any other way to get buyer leads aside from paying a massive referral fee.
It's the institutionalization of the buy side of the business. That's what's happening right now. That's the massive.
Explain that. Explain that.
Listen, you've got $7.2 billion that have come in our industry. You've got Realogy that is saying, We're gonna basically do lead generation and then sell you our leads. You got Realtor.com with Opcity. You got Zillow. You got, I mean, like I could show you the list of all these companies. HomeLight, right? And these are all good men and women, but they're like, look, 25% is the minimum, and relocation, right? One of my board members.
That's the biggest racket.
Oh my god! Like
holy.
42. Like so, and I'm not gonna say his name in fairness because he would be hated for this, but you know, he started a relo company. He ran Prudential's relocation company a million years ago when. Before Berkshire Hathaway, they made so much money it was bananas. And
off
back then they
the,
were
off
only
of the
charging
agents though. Like it all comes out of the agent's pocket.
Well, they generate the lead.
They generate the lead, right?
Yeah,
so here's the thing:
they
like,
generate the lead. I see.
I hear you, but that like they're charging the agent for all of the costs
except for generating the lead.
But they secured the client.
Right.
And whoever
I hear.
Secures
yeah.
the
I get
client
it.
Wins.
I
that
get it.
Is the game.
Right.
That, right.
Like, yeah.
And if you're on, if you're gonna focus on buying leads, it's going to get on the buy side.
Yep.
It's going to, in my opinion, get more and more expensive. So you could be working for 50% of the commission.
No doubt.
Basically forever.
Yes.
At that point.
Yes.
So.
But you know, but here's the thing. So, if, you know, I was just in London and London, the average commission is like 1.5%. Australia, it's like, you know, 2.5% total. Right?
Total.
And yeah. And by the way, no buy side. It's all list. You either list houses or you die.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. There's no cooperation. Like literally, hey, Nicole and I are looking for a property in Vienna in District 1. And we call you because we see the same listing on 7 different portals. At 7 different prices, and the seller has it as a FSBO. Like, that's Europe. No MLS. I call Byron. I'm like, hey, Byron, my wife and I are in town, and we're looking at apartments, and we'd like to get together. First of all, the average time before he calls me back is 10 hours. I'm not kidding. We've done
Europe.
A massive study on this. Like, 10 hours, well, they're drinking wine and hanging out. And
taking
out,
a nap.
Whatever, they're taking a nap. Like,
that's glorious.
Not all Europeans, Nicole. But it actually is kind of great.
1%? 2%?
But if I do actually get you on the phone and I say, gosh, I saw that lovely 3-bedroom, 2-bath with a 1-car garage. We'd love to see it this week. Would that be possible? This is normally what happens. Yeah, I don't have that listing anymore. They don't go, hey, Jill, do you have a 3-bedroom, 2? I got a buyer on the phone. Like that's how the rest of the world operates. In the U.S., everybody's figured out buy side is half the transactions. It's half of $86 billion in commissions. $86 billion in commissions. And you know what? Everybody wants to stick a needle into that vein and pull out some of that gravy.
So control.
That's not a racket. That's the institutionalization
of real estate. That's just what's happening.
Estate.
So control the inventory. Yep. Now, how would you market yourself as a buyer agent that doesn't have listings, or we just say, my opinion, you'd say, screw that, I'm gonna go get listings.
So so this has been a debate for you know a lot of people you know in Team Plus.
Because some people are like, Tom, I'm a great buyer's agent.
And
well,
the
but
world,
some teams are run that way,
and
though, too,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Some teams are run that way.
So I'm gonna make a hardline statement. So either the agent that is running the team has to like basically learn to live off less, right, to maintain the commission splits and standards of their existing team with their agents, or the agents have to realize that there's a major chunk coming across, right, on this transaction before it gets to you, and if they're bottom of the funnel, every client's going to take a lot of time. Let's make no bones. Like,
absolutely.
The rare, oh my God, I saw one house, let's write it up, I'm all cash, no negotiations.
Yeah.
How many times that happened a decade?
Happened to me once last year. But
okay, so, well, congratulations. Yeah. You're a baller, right?
So lucky.
He is a baller.
Right? So
once last year. Yeah.
So the commission game is going to change again. That's one side. But I am of the opinion, the teams that I work with that I say, listen to me, you need a listing division, or in a perfect world, like I'm old school, Everybody gets their own farm, right? I don't care if you're in New York City and it's vertical high rise, or you get this community, Joy's got that community, I got this community, and we're all gonna co-brand it together with the team leader's brand. It's 50-50 splits. We're gonna get every listing on the planet. You with me? And like my clients are like, oh my God, I'm in, you know, south of Dallas, and I'm, you know, I'm Phil, and everyone that is now buying in my area are Indian doctors. What do I do? And I'm like, you hire 3 Indian agents and you expand. And as soon as he was, that's a great idea. And now he's completely killing it. You don't allow silly limitations to stop you. And then, you know, you guys know, because you guys have been around my stuff. Like, I'm constantly pumping out, like, here's 33 different campaigns to go get listings.
Right.
There's no shortage of ways to do it, right? It's a mindset, though.
Right.
If you guys went to, come with me to Australia.
Ooh, lovely.
All they do is list houses.
Don't make me travel with Nicole.
I heard you guys don't travel well. Is that a racket, by the way?
That's a racket. Her traveling skills are a racket.
I'm improving.
Why? What's going on?
Well, Byron is very specific on his travels.
Yeah.
He has to bring a carry-on.
Yeah.
And I didn't bring a carry-on. And I tried to carry on my bag, but I had like this perfume that I brought, and I was like, dude, that's like a $400. Yeah. Yeah. So
trash.
Like, so of course he has our tickets on his phone. So he's like, here's my phone. You can go back and check your bag. I'll be in the Delta Sky Lounge. And I'm like, so I kept having to hit the screen because I'm like, I don't know his code. Nothing. Yes. So I go back.
I was already in.
You guys are like, what's the? It's like The Odd Couple. Like that's what's going on in my head. Like,
So I check my bag, and then as soon as we get on the plane, we were first class. So I'm like, oh, like, keep my hands.
I get my glass. We didn't pay for those tickets.
No, that was Greg. Wow. That was Greg. So I got a glass of wine, and I knocked it on my lap, and I was like, uh oh. And Byron's like, what's going on?
We haven't taken off yet.
Springtime, are you in white pants? Like, is it really good?
I had leggings on, but I didn't want him to think I was a bad traveler, right?
Yeah. So what'd you do?
So I was like,
I'm fine. I said, you got
nothing
like,
to see here.
Red wine all over you.
He's like,
were the leggings?
They were gray. He's like, why don't you stand up? And I'm like, I'm good. So I stood up and there's like a puddle.
Yeah.
Luckily his bag was above, so he gave me a pair of shorts.
Luckily I have a carry-on like a normal human.
So you like threw on like a pair of gym shorts and you're like, yo, I'm just working out, like just, you know, hitting the gym. Mm-hmm. Kind of sweaty.
But it was better than sitting in. We were going to California. That was like a 6-hour flight.
Arizona.
It was that was still 6 hours. So it was a really long flight.
No.
No. Yeah, it was. Four. Five.
It was
a lot of headwinds.
It felt like 12.
I travel a lot.
Easy.
Yeah. Okay. So that actually doesn't sound that bad. But back to your question. Look, at the end of the day, it's cliche. You list to last.
Right.
Yeah. You list to last. Right. I'm sitting at the Boomtown conference today, and these guys are arbitraging, you know, thousands and thousands and thousands of leads a month amongst all these, like 40% of the top 1,000 agents, like the 250 teams, 40% are in the room. Like these men and women are really good real estate team leaders, brokers, indies, etc. And I literally said to them, guys, how many listings did you take last year? Like, that's the game. Like, I understand, like, you buyer, but at a certain point you have to say to yourself, how many offers do I want to write in that experience versus how many offers do I want to receive.
Right.
I want to receive the offers and say, hey, Mrs. Seller, here's our 5 options, here's our 2 options, here's our 1 option, what do you want to do?
Right.
Versus like, how do I write this offer in a way that gets, you know, especially with price points today, everyone's like, did you see the latest thing that came out on KCM? There's no inventory.
Oh, yes.
Right, there's no inventory. Like everybody was like, oh my God, the world's going to fall apart. No, there's no inventory. We're basically in 2017 again, right? We're going to have a monster year in terms of transactions. Are there price points that are grossly overpriced? 1,000%. Will those properties sit? Absolutely yes.
Right.
You know, the demand at the super ultra lux is not where it used to be, but the rest of it is flying like crazy. I want to be the person with the listings getting the offers.
Right.
Hey guys, thanks for watching the video all the way to the end. I really appreciate all your engagement, all your comments. And if you like this content, if you want to see more, please, I've got 2 videos linked up here, or hit the subscribe button so that you never miss a video again.